Allah, guide us with those whom you have guided. Oh Allah, guide us with those whom you have guided.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen. Amma ba'd. فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وصحابك يا نور الله. The Holy Prophet صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم has said, the one who recites durood upon me once, Allah تعالى showers 10 mercies upon him. صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. I welcome my dear viewers of Madani channel back to our silsila, our role models. And this beautiful silsila, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, every episode we discuss regarding a pious wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or a sahabi of the beloved Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And with this mindset that we try to get lesson from this seerah and apply it in our day-to-day life so that we may attain success in this world and in the hereafter as well. Because by following the seerah of these pious ancestors, these pious buzurgan-e-deen, such great personalities, insha'Allah ta'ala, we are definitely getting on the path of Jannah. And insha'Allah ta'ala, when we act upon this seerah, our worldly matters also will become very successful for us. So insha'Allah Azza wa Jal, today we will speak about such a buzurg. We will speak regarding such a pious ancestor, such a pious wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whose name we often hear, and often in our Shajara Sharif, we also hear this name. None other than Shaykh Sayyidina Hazrat Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi's name we hear in our Shajara. So Shaykh Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh is the ninth Imam and Shaykh of the Silsila Qadiriyya Razaviyya Attariyya. And Hazrat Maruf Karkhi Radiyallahu Ta'ala Anhu was born in a city called Karkh. His name is Asaduddin and is famously known as Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh and Abu Mahfuz Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh. His father's name was Feroz. Initially, he was a non-Muslim. He wasn't a Muslim by birth. He was born to a non-Muslim family. But even as a child, he had great love for Islam, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had destined for him to become a Muslim, and not only a Muslim, to become a leader of millions of Muslims. So since his childhood, although he was born in a non-Muslim family, he had the love and affection for Islam to such an extent that when he was young, most of his friends were Muslim children. And often he talked to his parents regarding accepting Islam. His father was not pleased with this and enrolled him to study under a priest of their religion. The first question the priest asked was, "Tell me, son, how many people are there in your family?" So Hazrat Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Ali replied that we are so and so people in our family. Then priest asked regarding the basic beliefs of their religion. So Sayyidina Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi replied in the negative, that I do not accept this, I do not believe in this, my faith is not in accordance to this. Sayyidina Maruf Karkhi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi states himself, even during my time as a non-Muslim, my heart did not accept to say what my teacher, that priest, commanded me. When I refused to say whatever he wanted me to say, meaning the basic beliefs of that religion, he began to beat me severely. The more he beat me, the more he hit me, the more I rejected his teachings. He finally became fed up of me and asked my father to imprison me. I was thus locked in a room for 3 days, and every day I was given one bread, which I did not even touch. When I was taken out, I ran away. As I was the only child to my parents, they were very sad, and they sent a message to me saying that I should return to them and I would have the right to accept whichever faith I wished, and that they too will accept the same faith as me. I then went to Hazrat Ali Raza Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Ali and accepted Islam at his hands. I then went home with this most valuable gift of Iman and Islam, and Alhamdulillah, my parents also became Muslims. A child, and how much he had passion to accept the religion of Islam. What a beautiful mindset he had regarding Islam. From such a young age, he accepted being imprisoned. He accepted being locked for 3 days. He spent 3 days and three nights without eating anything. Why? Because he had the passion that I want to become a Muslim. I want to be a Muslim. I want to act as a Muslim. I want to practically implement Islam in my life. And we are Muslims by birth. But unfortunately, we do not value this priceless gift. Why? Because perhaps we did not have to work for it. We did not have to strive for it. Or maybe we were just born in the Muslim family, so we do not know what the importance of Islam is. We do not know how many people sacrificed their lives, their wealth, their time for this beautiful religion to come to us so easily. That's why we do not value it. Let's value this great treasure of Iman. Let's be thankful towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And without wasting any time, let's try to become practicing and following and obedient Muslims. Sayyidina Sheikh Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi studied under the care of Hazrat Ali Raza rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi and also attained education from Hazrat Imam Azam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. He attained spiritual training in the care of Hazrat Habib Ra'i rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. He was a very pious personality and one of the most distinguished arifs of his time. Arif refers to a specific level of wilayat. He was on a very high level of wilayat and he was a very distinguished, well-known wali of his time. He also served many great personalities such as Hazrat Dawood Ta'i rahmatullahi ta'ala ali, who also blessed him with khilafat. He used to call out the azan with true love and affection. And when he would reach the words of Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, the hair on his body would stand. He would get goosebumps and his entire beard would become stiff and he would begin to tremble to such an extent in the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it seemed as if he would fall to the ground just now. Imagine how much taqwa there was. Reading azan, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, but he is trembling with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is trembling with taqwa. That's how much he feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much do we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sayyidina Ma'ruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi is amongst our mashayikh, is amongst our peers. But how much do we follow him? Yes, he is our peer. We do read his name in our shajara. But how much do we follow him? He was a person who had high level of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much do we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we the same when we are alone? Are we the same when we are in public? Are we the same? You should ask yourself. I should ask myself. Every person watching me on Madani channel should ask himself, am I same when I am alone? Or I act as if I'm pious when I'm in front of people? Do I do good deeds of ibadat for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for the sake of the people? We should think that I commit sins when I'm in my privacy and when I am in front of the people. I'm totally different. Allah Ta'ala watches you when you are in front of the people or whether you are in your privacy. Allah Ta'ala knows what you do. In fact, Allah Ta'ala knows what you intend. In fact, Allah Ta'ala knows what you think, what you are going to do. Allah knows all. Allah sees all. But we do not take lesson from this. We should also develop this feeling of fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts. And this will help us refraining sins, inshaAllah azza wa jal. We should make intention that whenever there is any whisper of shaitan in our mind of committing a sin, we should immediately recall that Allah Ta'ala is watching me. Allah Ta'ala is looking at me. Allah Ta'ala knows what I have thought of. Allah Ta'ala knows what I am going to do. Allah Ta'ala is watching. Allah Ta'ala is seeing. Allah Ta'ala is all-knowing. We should keep this in our mind always. And by this, we will help ourselves from refraining from sins. Furthermore, Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi would spend lengthy nights in the masjid making ibadat, istighfar and weeping in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Sirri Sakhti rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, whatever I have attained is through the sadaqah of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Sayyidi Abdul Wahhab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, I have not seen anyone who divorced himself from the world like how Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi did. He secluded himself from the world, from the material world, from the worldly luxuries. He kept himself way far from all these things and he diverted his attention only towards the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much. He spent lengthy nights worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much so that people said that how much Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and secludes himself from the worldly luxuries. We haven't seen anybody doing like this like him. Along with all these characteristics of being so obedient servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having such a great level of taqwa, he was also a great personality when it came to his habits and character, when it came to his nature. He possessed deep love for the poor and the orphans. Hazrat Sirri Sakhti radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, I once saw Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala ali gathering dates on the day of Eid. So I stopped and asked the reason for this. He said, that young boy is crying because all the other children have new clothes and he has nothing on this day of Eid. Thus, I decided to collect some dates, sell them and buy them something new. Just imagine the day of Eid, he's collecting dates. Allama Sirri Sakhti rahmatullahi ta'ala ali asked him that, Ya Sayyidi, why are you doing so? He says, one child hasn't got new clothes. I will sell these dates. I will buy him new clothes. You know, sometimes when we're not in a mood of giving something out, we make excuses. I do not have it. I don't have it. I can't give you. So this, that, I forgot my wallet. I forgot my purse. I don't have anything on me. Things like that. But this personality, although in reality he did not have anything, but he worked hard to sell those dates and to use that money to buy new clothes and to present it to that orphan child. Just imagine the level of kindness, softness and love towards the poor people. Hazrat Sirri Sakhti radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, I said, Huzoor, there is no need for you to do this. I will make sure he gets something on the day of Eid. I then took the boy with me and bought him some new clothes. After I did this, a noor entered my heart, which caused me great pleasure and my condition became very different. By seeing his shaykh doing this, Sayyidina Sirri Sakhti, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, acting upon the footsteps of his pira murshid, Sayyidina Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, helped his pira murshid and he helped that poor person. As a result, a noor entered his heart. So our mashaykh, when we follow them, when we act upon their footsteps, why won't we get blessed? Of course, we will also attain blessings in our heart. We will attain satisfaction in our heart. We will also get blessings in our houses, in our lives, in our ages, in our day-to-day routines, in our businesses, in our world. And of course, on the day of judgment, our akhirah will also be very beautiful. Sayyidina Maruf Karkhi, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, once his wudu broke. So he immediately made tayammum. Those who saw him doing this said, Huzoor, the river Tigris is right in front of you. Why did you make tayammum? He said, it is possible that I may pass away by the time I reach that river Tigris. River is right in front. But he is afraid that by the time I get to that river, maybe I won't be able to make it. Maybe my death would reach me before I could reach the river. So he made tayammum at the very same spot, so that not even a single second remains such that he is in the state where he does not have wudu. He always stayed in the situation of wudu. And thus, we should also try to stay in the situation of wudu. Amir Ahl-e-Sunnat, Damat Barakatuhum Al-Aliya, quotes a very beautiful narration in his book, The Laws of Salah. He quotes that Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam advised Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that, son, remain in the state of wudu as much as you can. And in the very same book, Amir al-Sunnah Damud Barakatuhum al-Aliya also quotes that a wahi was sent towards Sayyidina Musa ala Nabiyyina wa alayhi salam that, O Musa, if you face a calamity when you are not in the state of wudu, then blame yourself only. Staying in the wudu has so many barakat. Staying in the wudu has so many virtues, has so many blessings. And thus we should also try that we stay in the state of wudu, we stay in the state of purity how much ever we can. Once one of Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi's friend asked him the following: what is that has caused you to abstain from the world and from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remain in seclusion, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is it the fear of death and the grave, or the fear of hell, or the enthusiasm of attaining Jannat? Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi beautifully replied to this question that, why are you secluding yourself from the world? Are you afraid of Jahannam, or you are greedy for Jannat, or you are afraid of your death or the grave? Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi replied so beautifully. He said, oh my friend, you discuss such minor things with me. What are all these worth in front of the Creator, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? All these are but humble subjects of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you taste the pleasure of His closeness, then you will not think of any of the other things. Look at the state of thinking. How much he drew himself nearer towards the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he did not care about anything else. His main objective of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to attain the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He secluded himself from the world and he diverted his attention only towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only towards his creator. Sayyidina Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, such a great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave the ummah so many advices which we may follow now as well. Some of the great words of wisdom which Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi mentioned: there are three signs of a true man. There are three signs of a true man: to fulfill one's promise, to praise without a motive, and to give without being asked to give. A person who fulfills his promise is a true man, is a real man. A person who praises someone not with the intention of gaining something, but wholeheartedly, with true heart and with sincerity, who praises someone. And thirdly, that person who, without being asked to give something, gives something. A person who is not demanded to give something, but he himself gives things out of his love and out of sincerity and out of his generosity and kindness. That's the third sign. These three signs are the signs of a true man. Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi would say, protect the tongue from self-praise like you protect it from sinning. That self-praising yourself would lead you towards the direction of pride, boasting, and being arrogant. So protect your tongue from praising yourself. Do not praise yourself. Consider yourself to be the lowest of the entire mankind. You should always think that I am the most sinful person on the planet Earth. A person should not praise himself. This is the advice of our role model, Sayyidina Hazrat Maruf Karkhi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. He would often also say this, that to desire paradise without doing good deeds is a sin, and to desire intercession without protecting the sunnah is a type of pride, and to be hopeful of the mercy while sinning is arrogance. That a person who desires to get the intercession of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, but does not act upon the sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is doing wrong. You want the intercession of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then act upon the sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. If you desire paradise, then do such actions which may lead you towards paradise. If you desire the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then try your best to refrain from sinning. And in case, if we get into the trap of sinning, then we should not delay in returning back to the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make tawbah in the bargah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to turn back towards our master, towards our creator, and sincerely repent of our wrongdoings. Sayyidina Maruf Qarqi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi would also say, love is not attained through education and training, but it is bestowed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That love is something that which Allah ta'ala grants you. The love for Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, the love for Ahl Bayt, the love for Sahaba Ikram, the love for Awliya Allah is not a thing which may be obtained by education, but it is such a thing which is bestowed upon a person by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are the ones who take the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We are the ones who take the name of Ahl Bayt. We are the ones who take the names of Sahaba Ikram. We love them all. And alhamdulillah, this is the karam and fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. May Allah ta'ala grant us the tawfiq that we always spend our life on this path and we practically implement these teachings in our life. May Allah ta'ala grant us the barakah of Sayyidina Imam Maruf Qarqi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Ameen. Bijahin Nabiyil Ameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
O Allah, guide us with those whom you have guided. O Allah, guide us with those whom you have guided.